In the previous video, we set up a Ruby on Rails development environment using a custom Docker image that we built to run our application and a Postgres database image. Today, we're going to layer another tool from the Docker toolbox on top of that to make creating and tearing down our development environment even easier. With the way that we currently have our development environment up, we've set up an app container and a database container based on the blog and Postgres images, but we manually have to set up all the environments between those and the networks that they use. Today, we're going to layer a tool called Docker Compose on top of this in order to orchestrate spinning up these containers for us and making sure all of that wiring that we had to do with our long Docker commands is set up automatically. The first thing that we're going to have to do is to create our first Docker Compose file. Docker Compose uses a formatting language called YAML in order to structure the data, but it looks a little bit weird and you have to be aware of white space in front of these things. So it's each layer that it's nested down is another context. So it'll be inside of volumes. We'll have one database data section. This will make more sense as we get further on. So we have volumes and then we have services that we're going to be setting up. And the volumes, this actually will address an error that we didn't even talk about, but I knew was going to be there in the way that we previously set up our database container. And that is when you would tear it down, you would actually lose all the data that was already there. We've used volumes currently to share our code from our machine into a container, but you can also use volumes to persist data that's inside of a container to your Docker host. And then when you spin up a container again, you can connect to that volume in the exact same spot and see that data again. So that's what we're going to do with our database now. So our first service is going to be called DB, and this corresponds to the name that we want to think of it as, which is we named our container DB. Makes sense to call the service DB. We want it to work off of the Postgres image. We want it to use an ENV file called .env. And this is actually so that we don't have to manually set up our Postgres user and Postgres password like we did previously. And then we want to map that volume to DB data. So that particular volume, we want to mount that on var lib PostgresQL data. And this is just the data directory that Postgres uses in order to, this is where it actually stores the database. Next up, we're going to create our application. And this will use a little bit different thing. So we currently inside of our Rails application, we have a Docker file. And if Docker Compose, it can build Docker files for you. So you're not going to use an image. You're going to build from what we currently have as configuration. And in this case, we want to build that Docker file and have that be the image that we use for app. We're not going to use the blog image that we had previously used. It's going to use the exact same configuration, but Docker Compose is going to create a separate name for it and manage it for us. We also want to point to the same ENV file. Oops. And then for our volumes, we're going to save from our current directory, which is this dot, into user src app. And this is the same thing that we did in our long command when we were sharing things through. We also want to map ports. And you can do this with 3000 to 3000, which is just another piece of that long Docker command. And then one thing that we didn't have before is we want depends on, and this to be DB. And what this means is that you can't realistically start our application container if the database isn't running. So when we run Docker Compose, we want it to start the database first and then start the application. So we'll save this, and then we need another file too, and that's going to be the .env file. The .env file is similar to what we did when we were exporting things, except for we're going to skip the word export. So we'll say Postgres user. It's going to be CoderJourney. And then Postgres password is going to be ABCD1234. We'll save both of these files and then bounce back over to our terminal. I don't have either of the containers running currently, but if you do, you're going to want to stop those using the command docker stop dbinapp. And then we're also going to remove those containers because Docker Compose is going to create containers with different names, and then it'll manage those directly. So these, we'd never connect to these containers again manually. So we'll docker rm dbinapp. And so now if we look at docker psa, which shows all containers, we don't have any more containers that aren't even stopped either. So we're going to remove our network too, because we will have one created for us by Docker Compose. It does quite a lot for us. So docker network rm blog, we'll remove our blog network. And then the next thing for us to do is to run Docker Compose. So it's docker compose with a dash. And then we just want it to say up. We'll see what it does. Well, it looks like I actually have a typo in my Docker Compose. So let's bounce back over there and fix that. This is supposed to say false, not fase. So change that, save it, and come back over. Oh, interesting. Apparently, it worked fine when we did it before, but Docker Compose isn't liking the shape of this. So our Docker file is a little bit messed up. So we'll bounce back over. And what it's saying is that it must end with a slash. So we're going to end that there. And we'll try it again. There we go. This is going to have to run through and do the bundle install for us, just like it did when we built the image ourselves. So I'm going to pause this, and we'll bounce back when it's done. Okay, now that we're finished, I've stopped what we were doing by hitting Control-C, but let's look back at a little bit of this trace. So Postgres looks like it's running. You can see these logs here from db underscore 1, but then app up here says it boots Puma, the Rails server's running. And then it says it's already running and exits, which is a little bit odd. If we look again, nothing's running. And actually, duh, nothing's running. I just stopped everything that was running. But let's try to spin these up again. So we'll do docker compose up. And this time we'll pass a dash D flag so they'll both start daemonized. And we don't have to toss in anything else. By default, docker compose will start all of our services. So it goes off and starts both. And we actually... most of the commands that we use within Docker, we have a Docker Compose version of those. So we have a Docker Compose PS, which will only show us apps or services that are running that are from our own project. So if we look now, we have both of them running. So let's bounce over to Rails and see what we get. Ah, there's no database because we're now using a different container. So for this, we can use Docker Compose run, we tell it the service we want to run and then the command. So this is equivalent to us saying we want to run, you know, docker run with the blog image and then run this command. For this one, we want to say run using the image that corresponds with the app service, and we want to run rake db setup. Now that that's finished, let's bounce back over to Rails. If we refresh this page, we should see hello from Docker. So there we go. We replaced all the complicated Docker commands that we previously had with two files in Docker Compose. And that will allow us to run Docker Compose up and Docker Compose stop to spin up and stop our services in the application that we're developing. I hope that you liked this video. If you did, I would really appreciate it if you would share, subscribe, and like it. And please give me any feedback that you have and let me know what you want to learn about.